Hello, 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 assalamu alaikum, ji ayanu, pakhair ragale, ni hao, chune shumme, wash mule, ohai, gunzaimus, guten morgen, hola, bonjour, privyat, kaifahal, hale shama chatore, ahlan wasalan marhaba, buna, mucho, gracias, suaviyah, and a very amazing good morning to everybody who's tuned into PTB World and watching World this morning, alongside the very fantastic Shahzad Khan. I hope that everybody out there is doing great and are ready to kickstart their day with us. Ladies and gentlemen, today the show is going to be a very different one, and it's because of the fact that over here at PTB World, and particularly on our morning show, I think that we are recognized for a reason, and that reason is that we always want to promote the talented youngsters of Pakistan. And I think that it is essential for all of the media houses to do so, and it's because of the fact that we have 60% of our population is all youngsters. And whenever we speak about youngsters, obviously they have a very different mindset towards life these days as well. Some wants to be a painter, someone wants to be a musician, somebody wants to be an actor, somebody wants to be a politician, somebody wants to be a software engineer, a mathematician. And I think that since the day that we have been on this journey, we've always tried our level best to do it in terms of the other person or the other party's convenience as well. So I'm going to share an incident which happened like a week before, and I'm sorry that I'm kind of promoting my own self or the show over here, but I think that it'll be in all honesty. And so we have seen, I've been doing this show for last 6 years now, alhamdulillah, and we have interviewed a lot of people who went into stardom right after they were interviewed on our show as well. And I'm sorry that I have to say that, but that's how it is. I'm not going to name anybody, but this is how it is. So this gentleman, a week or almost 10 days ago, he approached me. I was backstage at an event. You know, I was there with Asim, and you know, since he's a friend as well, so he was singing on the stage. It was just, you know, we were just enjoying, and this gentleman walked up to me and he was like, Shahzad bhai, maine yes. So I said, Shahzad bhai, you know, we have been to so many shows, but there's this one show we always want to be on. And I was like, are you going to talk about my show? And then he was like, yes, we want to be on your show. And whenever you can adjust us, please let us know. So that's something which we did. And we always want people to come onto our show as well, whether they write to us on our Facebook or Twitter or anywhere. So this particular gentleman, he's very respectful for me. It's because of the fact that he started his musical journey as a solo artist. But now he's actually converted into a band. They even performed for Battle of the Bands as well. They were in the top 20 out of 700 bands. And I think that that's quite an achievement. And it's not really important that you win one day and, you know, the other day the life is going to change. So life is a process. That's what I believe. And it's not that you have one destiny, you know. So you reach at one destiny, you look for another one. You reach there, you look for another one. So this is what this gentleman has been doing as well. And whenever we speak about music, my career started as a video jockey as well. I was always very keen about music, especially Pakistani music as well. And I think that people are doing wonderful things. So today, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a musical journey in the first half of the show. And he's a great artist. He's a great singer. Yeah, it's a band now, ladies and gentlemen. We're very lucky that we've actually been joined by the band Vajd, and they are over here in the studios with us. Namely, ladies and gentlemen, on my right hand side, we have Mr. Asim Khan. Hello, assalamu alaikum, Asim. How are you?
I'm good. What about you?
Absolutely perfect. Thank you very much for joining us. It's wonderful to have you alongside Asim. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been joined by somebody who's very good looking. And he's representing our culture as well by wearing a Sindhi
yeah.
Ajay. And he's on rhythm guitars as well. He's none other than Mr. Yeah. Jazeb Khan. Hello, assalamu alaikum, Jazeb. How are you?
Walaikum salam. How are you?
Absolutely
fine.
Perfect. Bahut shukriya aane ke liye. Thank you very much for joining us. And last but not the least, ladies and gentlemen, when upon my inquiring that, you know, what's your name? He was like, UD. And I was like, you're going to be on television. How can we write UD? People need to know your name. That's how people know me. And I was like, but what is your real name? So ladies and gentlemen, we're very lucky that we've actually been joined by Daud Rahat, a.k.a. UD. Hello, Daud. Assalamu alaikum. How are you?
Wa alaikum salam. I'm fine.
Thank you very much for joining us. So
thanks,
I'm going to start my
us.
Conversation with you. Okay. Why is your name UD?
Because it's my nickname. My mother gave
so
me
UD.
This name. Yes.
Or UD or UD or, you know, the way they pronounce it. Is it different or is it just UD?
It's the same UD. The spellings of UD are Y, U and D.
So your mother is
yeah.
very cool, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. He came up with. I mean, imagine all my life I've lived with a nickname, Bhai. You know, so everybody, even my father, even my grandfather, Even my Nana Boo, everybody used to call me Bhai. And imagine that, you know, if there's a friend and it's a lady, imagine if she asks for your nickname, can you even tell her Bhai? So UD, I think, is a very safe thing. You're doing a great job. That's great. But other than that, let's talk about Vaj now, because you were a solo artist, Asim, before, and then you formed a band. So why from solo artist to a band in the first place?
Basically, when I started my journey on that time, and I wasn't with the band, and I was just thinking to be a solo artist is good. But after some time, I realized that I have my own musician. I should have my own musician.
Yes.
And I started the journey.
Yeah.
And after I go to Pepsi Battle of Bands, and
yes,
that was a nice start.
Yeah.
And now we are working in Islamabad and Lahore as well.
Masha.
So the things are going on. Just take a start in
yeah,
the start,
exactly,
and the things will go on.
Exactly. And Asim is very correct over here, ladies and gentlemen. All you have to do is take a step, and Allah has many different ways of showing the way too as well. But how did it come across your mind that, you know, Jazeb and UD are actually going to be your band members?
It's like Jazzy, he's my old friend basically.
Okay.
And he's a very great guitarist. He's a sessionist as well.
Yeah.
Then we were just talking about on a cafe. We are sitting on that time.
Yep.
And I just came to him and just talked to him. And I told him, I am making a band.
Yeah.
If you are interested, or yeah, if you want to be with me,
yep,
then you will come.
Yeah.
And he just said to me, bro, I am always with you at any cost or at any place.
Wow.
So then we just started.
And it's great. And it's wonderful as well, which is why I'm going to ask Jazeb as well. So Jazeb, you know, as Asim said, that you're a great guitarist. I've seen you play as well. So, you know, for all of those people who are good with their instruments, they're always in demand. You know, there are a lot of musicians who will call you, Jazeb, come do sessions with us too as well.
Yeah.
So imagine if you have been invited by Atif Aslam to do a session, and then on the other hand, it's Asim's concert.
Yeah,
which one are you going to do?
Definitely, I'll go for my own band. That is first. Obviously, that is my first
priority.
I don't think so
because there is Atif Aslam and Asim.
It's not like that because I used to do as a sessionist. I do work as a sessionist guitarist, but if it comes about my own band, then definitely I will promote my thing as well, because it's my own thing.
Yes. I really appreciate it.
Wow, that's great. We can do that afterwards. I'm excited for sharing it. And what about UD? So how did UD become a band member? Asim. Yeah.
UD, I was searching for a musician. My friend gave me his number.
Yeah.
And I just called to him and I asked, will you join me?
Yeah.
He said to me, no, I am doing some work and I am doing some events, so I'm not interested. Okay, fine, no problem. After some time, I call him again.
Yeah.
Then he said to me, okay, yes, what's your plan? I told him my plan.
Yeah.
This is the whole thing. And on that time, I was having 10 team members.
Wow.
Or rubabist, electric, bass, and these all things. But he just told me, I'll go with bass.
Yeah.
And he started bass, and he's a very good player.
Wow. Yeah. And it's great. And ladies and gentlemen, obviously, we're going to listen to that too as well. But people might not know, you know, actually, the bass guitarist is one, you can consider him the backbone and the drummer.
Yeah.
You know, these two people are actually the backbone of the entire band as well.
Yeah.
And then people get to follow too as well.
This is a difficult instrument. You have to play like...
It's not really that difficult. It's just four
it's
cables, and that's it. It's
easy
not that
four
difficult.
Guitarist.
But there are people who've done wonderful job as a bassist. For example, Khalid from Aro was a wonderful bassist.
Yeah.
And
it's difficult for me because I'm a singer. I don't play any instrument. That is why I'm
And we're going to dig in deeper as well. And he does not play an instrument because of the fact that he sings. He plays his own vocal cords as well, which is why we're going to put you to a test. What are you guys going to share with us today?
Oh, basically, I will start with a kalam.
Okay.
It's a kalam. Allah, basically, it's about Allah.
Yep.
It's about the Lord.
Yes.
So, wo bata rahe hain. He's telling us that I am the creator.
Yes.
Sab kuch mujhse hai. Everything belongs to me. So, I will start with this kalam.
All right. We'll definitely do that. But I think we'll have to hold our horses right now because we have to go for a break in a minute's time.
Okay.
Sure.
So speaking about Vaj, what I want to know is that you haven't released a single video so far or an audio as well.
What are your plans according to that? Because you're still doing covers. But when you have your own band, you have to make your own music as well.
Yes, we are on the making now.
Okay.
We are making our production house as well. We are just, I have written a lot of songs before.
Wow.
But I've also composed them. Wow. But now we are going to do something very good in some new time.
And different.
In this new year, inshallah.
Wow, that's
good. We are planning this.
That's good. So, Jazib, what kind of music can people expect from Vajd?
Well, it's kind of fusion of rock and Sufism. So we basically do Sufi rock. So okay. It's kind of a Sufi rock, you can say.
And in the recent years, we have seen that, you know, the trend of Sufi rock has increased quite a lot.
Because a lot of followers of Sufism, because we belong to Muslim community. So that's why we, you know, do the rock thing with Sufism. So it will sound so cool and so rock.
And he always wears like a rock star.
And
you can see.
And it's good. That's how rock stars are. I mean, I think that the finest rock star I've ever witnessed over in Pakistan is Mr. Ali Azmal. Doesn't really care what he's wearing. Doesn't really care who's sitting right in front of him. He is what he is. And I think that's how rock stars should be. But talking about music, you know, obviously one of the finest bands Pakistan has ever produced is Strings. And whenever you hear them performing live, it's a treat. Who did you guys take inspiration from when we talk about Sufi rock?
It's very simple, Janoon.
Janoon.
Salman, Ahmed, Ali Azmadi, as you said.
And now Janoon is back as well. So
it's back with a very great power. He just came back.
Yeah,
exactly. And it's great, which is why, ladies and gentlemen, we really need to put them to test. But we are actually going for a short break. Don't go anywhere, because when you guys will come back, we're actually going to listen to a wonderful kalam by Vajd. Let's do it.
चाहत एक मेरी चाहत पर हो वही जो है मेरी चाहत पे मंसूर मैं हाँ आप तजल्ली मैं हाँ कोई तूर मैं आप यहाँ भुला मैं राजा मैं ही मैं कहो मैं थी मैं इबलीस दरब हाँ मैं पीरा दा पी मैं राजा मैं ही मैं कहो मैं थी मैं इबलीस दरब हाँ मैं पीरा दा पी बड़े आकुन फयकुन मैं पुकांगा सूर मैं हाँ आप तजल्ली मैं हाँ कोई तूर मैं आपे हाँ बुला मैं आपे मंसूर मैं हाँ आप तजल्ली मैं हाँ कोई काफी मैं बहुदी हूँ तू ही मैं तू मैं ही रंगबू मैं हुसैन दी काफी मैं बहुदी हूँ बड़े आकुन फैकुन मैं हाँ मैं पुकांगा सूर मैं हाँ आप तजल्ली मैं हाँ कोई
just really amazing you guys and I guess this is the type of performance which is why I am back so all of you who are watching right now well of course I was not in the first segment but here's the thing me being a student Shahzad I really have to like juggle between all these parts as well so I just rushed to my class and while sitting there I was watching you know all the update in our group and I was like hold on this is an amazing band I really need to be there for them so here I am and you guys are doing an amazing job mashallah
that's great Shahzad we definitely like your passion as well which is why you should always be thankful that you've got a great team to work with
of
as well
of course I'm always genuinely thankful
yeah and it's always great but you guys definitely did a great job as well you know Shiza for a while did steal the thunder but it's perfectly you guys did a great job and you know while Jazeb was on the guitar I was like he's putting too much effort into it and it was great and the kind of vocal Asim you've got is very different but obviously there's a lot of work which is required to be done you know to expand the horizon gala jo kholna jisko kehte hain
but I don't do most of the time I eat everything I try I go with all foods because I'm foodie I'm too much foodie so I don't skip anything
okay
I taste all the things and after that Allah is Allah ki taraf se it's all about from Allah and that's I'm happy with it maine kabhi kisi se nahi sikha
okay
theek hai but cheezein chal rahi hain and the things goes on and it's good
and it's great I think that's how it is but there's never anything wrong in learning as well you know to improve and I think that this process goes on but other than that you know there's one more thing and that is that I can see these two rings which you're wearing with stones on them as well so is it I mean what is the correct word for using it is it superstition or is it a set of belief that you carry that you have to wear these stones why do you wear these stones or rings
there is no belief
okay
I like to wear ring
that's you like it. To wear rings
I like this stone
yeah is this something to do with your I mean birth date or something
no it's not on that
okay. no all right
it's not on that
all right
I just wear it because I like it and I love this stone. It's an Aryakoot. It's have a reddish. The thing that is why I just wear it.
And what about the other one?
It is a stone, but it's not mine. It's a stone. I just wear it. Yeah.
All right. And you know, even Shahzad, it even happened to me that you know, whenever when we were growing up, you know, so. from my house. You know, I never got the permission to wear rings or necklaces or anything of that sort. But then eventually, you know, so I'll see a friend of mine wearing a ring and then I'll nick that off and I'll be like, you know, I'll give it back to you. But that never goes back. Yeah, but that never goes back and it's not even with me as well. But,
all right. Yeah. So here's the thing. I know you have a question, but here's the thing. So I was also watching a bit of your show that Shahzad was doing backstage. And of course, you guys spoke about your inspiration and, you know, how you guys came here where you are today. But I want to take it on a lighter note now, and I think we have to play a very interesting game that Shahzad and I absolutely love doing with almost all of our guests. This is called Never Have I Ever. Do you guys know about it?
No.
Okay, so I'm going to tell you something. For example, never have I ever combed my hair, just saying. And if you have,
looks like that.
You have. Do we raise our hands if we have? Oh.
Yeah. All you have to do is say whether it's true or not. Okay.
Yeah. So you raise your hand if you have, and if you haven't, then we'll ask.
Oh, there's a lot of information coming out of these.
All right. So the first one to go.
But it's interesting.
It's very interesting. Yeah. Trust me, and it has to be the truth only. Yep. So never have I ever dined and dashed, like you know, you ate somewhere and didn't pay for it and just left. You have?
Okay. Yeah, so you are even supposed to let us know
the story
where
as
did
well.
You do it and how did you do it?
I was in my university.
Okay.
And I was with my friend. We ate a lot of stuff and we just move on like slowly. Pehle tu ja, phir main aa raha
hoon. Really?
Wow. And nobody came after you guys?
No, because wahan par bahut log the.
Okay.
There were a lot of crowd there.
A lot of people out there. Jazib, what about you? Did you ever do that?
No.
No, you have
I'm
never
not
done.
That much guts.
That's good. Judy, what about you?
No.
Have you done it? Have you had free food from your friends?
Aana
yaar, aaj to khana
khaya. A lot of time. You said to me.
So you don't do that. Okay, that's good. Okay. So the next one is, never have I ever used a fake account. Kabhi social media pe, have you guys tried doing that as well? Just
not
to slip into a pretty girl's DMs as well.
Not this type of stuff.
Yeah. Huh?
Not this type of stuff.
Never?
If a gentleman is having his personality, you don't need to do these type of things.
Mm. Okay.
So you don't
need to
fake
account
it.
Ever.
Yes, no.
Yeah, all right. What about you?
No, not at all.
I think I think I'm going to be thankful at this stage that there are other people making fake accounts on my name. I think
that's your promotion.
That's a good one. Yeah,
absolutely.
It's your promotion.
But recently, I think that I'm witnessing a lot of that I'm getting full of myself. So you know, you better show me the turf too as well. That okay? Hold on. Okay.
No,
so you know, we obviously need to strike a balance in between. So yeah, moving on. So never have I ever been dumped. Kisi ladki ko pucha, haan bhai. To usne kaha ki nahi, aap nahi, bhai.
Have you been though?
Yeah, I think everybody goes through it. Yeah.
Can't relate.
Can't
you
relate.
Have been?
Can't relate.
Many times.
You have
it
been?
It happens. When you are with friends and you like someone, you just saw a girl and she's pretty. And I just told to my friend like, yaar main jaun, baat karun. Ja, ja. He know that.
Yeah.
She will say no to me.
Yeah.
But he will insist me. Go there and talk to her.
Yeah.
And I just go and Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum salam. Who are you?
Yeah.
Myself, I am Asim. So I don't want to talk to you. Why? If there is any reason. If my face looks ugly or what? I have many questions. I do many questions on that.
All right.
But she just said to me.
No.
Oh.
What did you do? What was
that's
the next
harsh.
Time?
That's
okay.
Harsh.
We will do it for the next time.
No, but when you go back to the same friend whom you actually asked, "Am I going?" I think he's the one laughing over here.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah,
they
and,
do.
And since Shiza asked me whether I've been dumped or not, so I was kind of thinking about it. I don't think that I've ever been dumped.
But you said yes first.
Yeah, because I think so that there have been situations where we've been talking, but then eventually I didn't feel like talking. So, so eventually, I don't know.
Not getting
so
you the can right call answers.
It, so you can call it dumb too as well. So it's okay.
But
what
he
about
raised
you?
His hand as well.
That was a school time.
Oh, okay.
You were very fast.
Writing letters and writing numbers.
I mean, you don't do things in school. I didn't even knew that something like this exists in school time. Yeah. Come on. So in school time, you were actually asking out women, I think.
Actually, he was 19 but he was in school.
somebody can take a little longer.
It's
okay. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so never have I ever prank called someone.
I think we all have.
Abhi tak nahi.
When there was a landline, I mean, of course, now everyone has a mobile phone.
Yeah.
You can tell who's prank calling you.
Yeah.
Then it sometimes, but not like it's a prank. We do in our friend circle.
Yeah.
But not like, we cannot say prank, it's on daily life.
Daily it's on Patreon, by the way. We do all the day, yeah. The prank calls.
It keeps us going.
Yeah.
And you know, this reminds me an interesting story which I'm going to share with people as well. That so when I got done with college, I had 3 months off to myself, and my father was of the kind that, you know, one should always work.
Okay.
So what we did was that we had a building, and you know, there was this office which was vacant. It had a telephone line in it as well. And it has chair. So I was just supposed to go to the office and look after, you know, what people are doing, yes, or other people, whether they're paying rent or time or not.
Right.
And it was like a 1 day or a 2 day job. So what would you do 28 other days? And so there was a landline. And I started calling people, lying on the table, you know, nobody coming in. And I was just talking to people, and that's it. After a month's time, my father came up to me and he was like, what have you been doing? You know, the phone bill's 50,000 rupees. And I was like, oh, that's something I never thought about. I was like, you're the one who's going to pay it. So whatever work I did, it actually got off into the imbalancing the phone bill as well. So ladies and gentlemen.
So you never got paid for that.
Yeah. So be smart with it. Okay. Don't do stupid things that it comes down to your parents. Because they shouldn't be paying for the kind of luxury that you're enjoying.
No, yes, absolutely. But it once actually backfired on us. We were living in Sakhar. So so there was this thing, CLI. Some phones had it, some didn't, right? So, all right.
Sometimes it's being cool to break some rules.
Yeah, so that's what we were doing as well, breaking rules. Huh? So with our friends, we were just calling other people. And this one person, of course, they got our number and everything. So later in the evening, with mom, baba came back and everything, they called and they're like, aapke ghar se hume call. You know, everything. They were just snitching on us for whatever reason. And well, we got caught and we were in big trouble. Just saying.
All right. So yeah, don't get yourself into trouble, ladies and gentlemen, even today. But you know, if you are supposed to give prank call anybody, there's this one option in your cell phone. Don't show my caller ID. And if it works, you can do that. And you can prank anybody. But don't do that, you know. And one last question.
Okay.
That is, have you ever stayed up all night?
Yeah.
Have you?
I think.
Yes.
A lot of times.
Doing what?
Because we are musicians.
No. Doing what? That's what we're interested in. You know, we're not
that
interested
was just
in
part
you guys
one of
up.
The questions.
Yeah. What were you doing when you stayed up all night?
Chilling
from the last night. Yes, chilling from this last night.
Yeah.
I was watching my season of Vikings.
Okay, so you were watching Vikings. So that's it.
Yes, I was watching it tomorrow.
Okay,
till tomorrow.
That's good. What about you?
Well, we used to do a lot of, you know, party stuff,
yeah,
and jam thing,
yeah,
and movies and a lot of other stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Which we cannot say on TV, but yeah, it's all right. That's what rock stars do.
Yeah.
Judy, what about you? You sleep, right?
I remember when we were practicing for Pepsi Battle of the Bands.
Yep.
We have stayed many nights outside.
Yeah,
from home.
And you've enjoyed.
Yeah,
yes. I think that's great. And I think that whenever you're on such a journey, you always enjoy it as well.
Yeah.
But right now, I believe that it's time that we sing another song.
Yes,
for
let's
all
do
our
it, guys.
Next
song.
Because we're getting to know them as well. They're a bunch of naughty boys, but it's all right. They're talented ones. So what are you guys going to share with us now?
It's an OST of our drama, Baagi.
Baagi. Oh, I love that song. I love that song. Baagi, ladies and gentlemen, people might have forgotten, was actually made on
have
the subject Kandil Baloch, and may her soul rest in peace. And it's a good watch. And the OST was loved by millions and millions of people.
Of course. That's so catchy.
Yeah. Yeah. And his vocal tone actually matches the kind of song it is.
Yes.
Let's
exactly
have it.
Baagi is also a kafiyat, you can say.
Yes.
Sometimes.
धूल उड़ती है या तन्हाई धूल उड़ती है या तन्हाई हर पल दर्पत मन सोदाई दूर मैं तुझसे हूँ ना रब लभे आना तू पीरा वे पीरा मैं हो जाऊँ ना बागी पीरा वे पीरा मैं हो जाऊँ ना बागी पीरा वे पीरा मेरा मन है दर्द वे पीरा मैं हो जाऊं ना बागी पीरा वे पीरा मैं हो जाऊं ना बागी और सपनों की ताबीरों से जाकी हूँ क्यों अपनों से बेगानी मैं लागी करते नहीं इश्क फकी बिन राजे पीरावे पीरावे पीरा मैं हो जाऊं ना बागी पीरावे पीरावे पीरा मैं हो जाऊं ना बागी पीरावे पीरा मैं हो जाऊं ना
Beautiful, nice. Yeah. Very, very loved beautiful. It. Very nice. Very mesmerizing early in the morning as well. And I think that we guys over here in the studios are having a great time.
Absolutely.
We hope that everybody out there is having a great time too as well, listening to Vajd. But whenever we speak about Vajd, what is the kind of music which people can actually look forward to? Because you guys are going into production as well. You guys are writing your own lyrics. And for any band, it's important to have their own music. So what are they looking for? What kind of message will your songs carry?
Vajd is like, it's kaifiyat, you can say. Yeah. It's a kaifiyat. Or in English, it's a rapture. That you goes into music deep to deeper. So this is the basic purpose that we named it Vajd. It's koi bhi song ho sakta. It's like any song that have some feelings in that, like Sufi. Basically, our motto is Sufi rock and Sufi as well.
Yeah.
But if we talk about some commercial or OST, it can be like that.
Exactly.
But it should be in some feelings and it should be grab your souls. It's a bit
and that's very important, which is why I'm going to ask you guys as well, because you guys are band members and you guys are the ones who actually produce music, you know, you're going to be playing that music.
Yes.
Since Asim does not play any instrument anyway. So what I need, So what I need to know is that I have seen a lot of bands over the span of 10 years. I've seen bands who have flourished a lot.
Yeah,
I've seen bands who are bigger names now, but I've seen bands who are nowhere to be seen.
Yeah.
And there's only one reason which I think is very common amongst them, and that is that the kind of music they were doing, they were just doing it for themselves. Nobody else actually wanted to listen to that kind of music.
Two kind of music, or you can say. The commercial music and the personal music.
Yes.
If you want to be a hit, you need to be throw something commercial for general people.
Exactly.
So basically we actually do a fusion of different instruments because we have right now we have no other instrument with us, the violin and the rubab. We do the fusion of different instruments and make some feel. And with that feel, we can throw our message through vocals.
Exactly. So and it's great. But which is why right now, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to do is, I think that I'm doing it so much these days as well, that whenever it's break time, I just kind of dig in deeper into their personalities and get to know them better. So while we were conversing, Asim actually told me that he can whistle very well. And we're not going to miss out this this part as well, because for the very first time, we're going to do it on television. So what we'll do is, you will whistle, you know, whatever you whistle.
Okay.
You will replicate it in a lead, and then you can replicate it in a strum. And that's going to be a wonderful fusion. Can
but
we do that?
But whistle will be not so loud.
No, you can
try. We have microphones.
So first you whistle. Then he's going to reproduce the tune on his lead, and then we can do it on the strums as well.
One by one.
So which song?
Any song, any one that they can replicate as well. Yes.
Okay. So I'll go
with a little alarm in it as well, so that you know he can do it on the lead.
chupke chupke. It's a ghazal.
Chupke chupke raat.
Yes.
Yeah, do it.
Go ahead.
Really nice. And I actually really sort of envy all of you because you guys are so talented, mashallah. Even Shahzad is. No,
you
I don't
are.
Even know how to whistle, to be honest. I don't even know how to whistle.
She's so good with hosting shows that you guys cannot even believe. Yeah, I think that even she's the backbone of our show too as well.
Oh, that's so sweet.
I think that's great. But thank you very much, guys, for being with us. It was wonderful to have you.
Thank you so much.
And we definitely wish you best of luck for your future endeavors as well. So we're going to do our wrap up. And then towards the end, you guys can sing one more song for our audiences as well.
Yes.
So is there anything you guys want to say before we wrap up?
Yeah, because a lot of people, youngsters right now must be watching you and they do maybe need an inspiration to take the first step, right?
Yeah.
To maybe venture into music or whatever. This is a camera. Speak to them. Inspire them.
Basically, I'll go with a sentence that there is consistency is the best tool.
Yes.
Do whatever you want to do, but do it constantly.
Exactly.
Mm.
Don't lose yourself.
Just keep on doing it.
Just keep on doing it.
That's exactly. Very smart.
That's great.
Yes.
That's a wonderful message as well. But ladies and gentlemen, if there's anything else, if there's any more you want to know about Wajd, please make sure that you write to us on our Facebook page, which is with the name of
Well This Morning.
On Twitter.
Well This Morning without a G.
On Daily Motion and GT.
Also Well This Morning.
The Fabulous Repeat is going to be at
5:11 PM tonight.
Till the next time.
Good
one,
morning.
Three. Good morning. Let's hear it. Come on, what are you guys going to sing for us?
So I'll go with a song of Khansa, who is my inspiration.
Wow.
Literally Khansa.
Wonderful.
So it's on
he's waiting for you to tell him which one it is.
Yeah.
Because
the
song.
Which one, bro?
Our signature song.
It has a name. Achha, achha.
Let's do it. Come on, let's do it. Which one?
So Shahzad bhai, it's on beautiful eyes or mast nazrein jo sabki hoti hain, khas taur pe ladkiyon ki.
Wow.
Aur ladkiyon ko ladkon bhi lagta hai.
है ना
मस्त नजरों से अल्लाह अल्लाह बचाए मस्त नजरों से अल्लाह अल्लाह बचाए मस्त नजरों से अल्लाह बचाए महजमालों से अल्लाह बचाए मस्त नजरों से अल्लाह बचाए महजमालों से अल्लाह बचाए
आपके बारे में बात हो रही है
थैंक यू सो मच सो स्वीट
इनकी मासूमियत पर न जाना इनके धोखे में हर किस नाना मासूमियत पर न जाना इनके धोखे में हर किस नाना लूट लेते हैं लूट लेते हैं लूट लेते हैं ये मुस्कुराकर लूट लेते हैं ये मुस्कुराकर इनकी चालों से अल्लाह बचाए मस्त नजरों से अल्लाह बचाए महजा चाहे उम्र जलवों में बसर हो ये जरूरी तो नहीं हर शबे गम की सहर हो ये जरूरी तो नहीं नींद तो दर्द के बिस्तर पे भी आ सकती है उनकी आगोश में सर हो ये जरूरी तो नहीं गम है या खुशी है तू मेरी जिंदगी है तू मेरी जिंदगी है तू मां का मरे रे सगम है या खुशी है तू